new release time for Power Platform Wave 2 2024. I'm going to do something a little bit different here, which is to go through the features across Power Apps, Power Automate, Power Pages, Copilot Studios, a little bit of governance in there, really important thing with AI Builder at the end that matters a lot. But I'm going to do this in a logical sequence and give each feature a rating. Let me know in the comments what you think about some of these as well. First up, Power Apps. And this is something that's been coming for a very, very, very long time that we've all been waiting for. Looks like it's going to come into preview very soon. Co-authoring in Canvas Apps. Multiple makers making this at the same time. This is something that's been a long time coming and definitely a 5-star feature. Everyone's going to be very, very happy to see this one. The next one here, I don't work with the code side of things very much, but for my friends in the community who do work with Canvas apps and want to get to the source code, this one is definitely a big deal. You will actually be able to, this improves the story of that no cliffs, low code to no code kind of approach, where the people who actually do have those skills to develop with code will be able to get in and work with the code repository for the Canvas app. Based on what I'm seeing of how level of excitement of people who work this stuff, I reckon a 4-star piece. Now, this is definitely my zone, model-driven apps. There is some improvements coming to the grid features, which I think are really, really important. Let's just pop this one up, 5-star piece here. This is a picture of what we've currently got. So this idea of this is the grid or the view, that there's a control in here where we can say group by something. There's more coming that's being announced in this release, and I will definitely have a video on this when it comes out. Make sure you've subscribed and give this video a like if you like the new release content. I believe you do. You tell me you do. I like doing it. So this allows you to do more than this. There's going to be the aggregation. I've started to see this come through a little bit where you'll be able to get things, especially if you're looking at something that has, you know, rows of sales figures or something like that, and you want to get that aggregation, the little subtotals in the grid. We're going to be able to do that, as well as minimum, maximum, average. Very cool stuff coming here. Can't wait to get my hands on this one. Power Pages. I'm just going to pick out one feature here that I think is really important. And the reason I think this one is important, we'll give this one 4 stars. This is a very highly requested feature, and I love it in the release notes when the start of it is in response to feedback from users. That's when you know that we're getting something that people are going to care a lot about. Enhancements to the file upload experience. So Power Pages is our portal experience where your external customers can come and interact with your data. They will be able to do more with the file uploads here. So firstly, bigger files it can handle, the drag and drop experience. The most important thing here that I'm looking at is this scanning the files for malware, which is obviously super important, and a streamlined experience from the maker point of view. Now, the next one is actually the biggest deal of the entire thing, sitting right in the middle here. I hope you've stayed with me this far. This one was announced at Build. This is definitely a 5-star feature. In fact, I'm going to give it 2 rows of 5 stars. I make the rules. This is the space to watch. This is where we change from the concept of AI as just a chat experience into AI acting as an agent, AI actually able to start to take on a process and do the process for you. So AI Flows here, preview August 24 is what's listed. This image is taken from the announcement at Microsoft Build. So what you can do here is something like examine the customer request. So this was a scenario where we had a cinema where someone requested a change to a booking. So instead of a person having to handle that manually, examine the request that comes in, figure out the option based on our policy document, and then use the policy document to help write the email. So there's a lot going on here, plenty more to come. Stay subscribed. I'm definitely going to be doing content on this. This is a really big deal. Governance. There's one little piece in here I wanted to call out. Not a sort of, you know, as big as the last one, change your world. It's definitely a 3-star feature here, is to be able to mask sensitive data fields. We do, you know, I do a lot of work talking to organizations that have sensitive data. If you're in finance, government, nonprofit, plenty of other industries as well, but those ones in particular, you've got all this customer data in there, but you don't necessarily want everyone who has access to those records to be able to see the sensitive information. If you've especially got high profile people in your database or vulnerable people, you need to make sure that that's not available for everyone to go in and get, you know, a celebrity's phone number. So I've just mocked up this screenshot just to kind of illustrate what it might look like. But this is something that takes a fair bit of effort to do right now. So this is going to be something that's going to be coming in as part of the platform to make it easier to do. Loving this one. Copilot Studio. I know I said AO Flows were the biggest deal, but within Power Platform, Copilot Studio is the biggest deal. There's a piece I'm going to come back to right at the end about AI Builder, which affects this. So make sure you're staying for that. Copilot Studio, there are sort of three features. It's a lot to get across. I can't even count my fingers anymore. Three features here that I think are great. So this world of building your own custom Copilot or using Copilot Studio to extend the Copilots we've got is huge. Insights, really, really important part of it. We're going to give this one 4 stars. At the moment, you've got the thumbs up, thumbs down, and you can certainly get that response in there. But this brings a much richer experience in here to be able to monitor the performance of your custom copilots, including understanding the themes of what the questions are that are asked and much more detailed insights on user satisfaction. Haven't got images or anything of this one yet, but this is just going to be really core, solidly important part of that creating a custom Copilot experience. This one is very cool. This is a piece that was announced at Build in November, and this little GIF here is from that. So this is the ability for the Copilot to respond to images, not just text. So at the moment, it's a very chat-based thing. The ability to upload an image and have the Copilot understand that. So you'll see here, we've got that sort of receipt analysis type scenario. I'm giving this one 3 stars. I feel like we can kind of do this in the platform already, so I'm not quite as woohoo about it, but I think having this in the Copilot experience, I suspect I'm underrating this. Tell me what you think. Suggested prompts. This is an example from just the Copilot from Microsoft 365. I just wanted to show you what I think's going on here. Down the very bottom here where it says draft an email to request more information, tell me more. If you've used Copilot at all, you'll start to see these. These are suggested prompts. So in that experience, the Copilot is surfacing things up. So image just for context there. The feature here is around saying that you can have those types of things in your custom Copilot, because especially as we start to build out custom Copilots that are connected to lots of different data sources, the user might not know that. So the idea of sort of putting something in front of the user to prompt them to go, hey, here's a thing you can do. So we can do this at the moment, but it's going to be a whole lot easier to have that as part of the products. I'm giving this one a 3 stars until we see exactly what it does. I've saved the most important part until the end here. AI Builder came into the platform with great fanfare a few years ago and then sort of didn't get a heap of attention, but now this is becoming really important. I'm just going to pull out one feature here, but the thing is that with AI Builder, the release notes, there's actually a stack of features in there, but they're all listed with a date of March 2025, which is the end of this new release wave period. I'm always a little wary about a whole lot of things that have a date that is at the end of the new release wave, because you can't be sure enough about the detail or when they're really coming. It's almost I almost read that as a bit of a placeholder, but I am reading it as there's effort and engineering work going into AI Builder, which I'm delighted about. So hopefully by the time we get to wave one next year, there'll be plenty of detail to say. I wanted to talk about the GPT prompts because this one actually has a November 24 date. This is an enhancement to a feature that already exists, and it's a really important feature that might have been a bit buried in the detail. So I'm going to definitely come back and do more content on this. This one works with flows, so you can trigger a flow to use it. You can put it in your apps. You can bring it into Copilot Studio. And what it essentially does is allows you to have an actual prompt that pulls data in. So for instance, if you've got a feedback survey coming in, you can take that input and use this to say, find these key pieces of information and then draft a personalized response to someone based on that. At the moment, most of the examples I've seen using this are quite simple. I do want to do more, but the feature here, back to the point of this video, is that you will be able to add unstructured data. So at the moment, this screenshot is sort of a current state. You can come in with the data and connect it up to Dataverse, but this feature now is expanding this, that you'll be able to connect this to websites and other unstructured data. I need to dig into this one more once we get our hands on it. So stay tuned, stay subscribed for that. If you're into Dynamics 365 Sales, I've got another video here. If you're into Copilot Studio, make sure you check out my playlist to get started with that. Thank you for watching.